Savior. When his mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found with child from the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was a good and just man and was not willing to expose her to public disgrace, Joseph considered to divorce her quietly. But an angel of the Lord came and appeared and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is that from the Holy Spirit, and Mary will have a son, and you shall call him his name Jesus, for he shall save the people from their sins." Now this was done that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, "Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel," which being interpreted is, "God is with us." Then Joseph was awakened from sleep, as the angel of the Lord had bidden him, and took unto him his wife. Matthew 1, 18 through 20, NIV.
And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Caesar was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, everyone to his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee out of the city of Nazareth unto Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was the house of the lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. Luke 2, 1 through 5.
Thank you.
while they were there, the time came for her baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son, and she wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in the manger, because there was no room for him in the inn. Luke 2:6-7.
And there were in that same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone around about them, and they were sore afraid. Luke 2:8-9.
Watch their flocks by night, all sleeping.
And the angel said unto them, Behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you, you shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there were angels and a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill to men. Luke 2:10-12.
And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. Luke 2:15-17.
Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king. And behold, there came men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is that child born of the king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and we have come to worship him." When King Herod the king had heard of these things, he was troubled, and all of Jerusalem with him. Matthew 2:1-3.
Then Herod, when he had privately called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the young child. And when you have found him, bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also. When they had heard the king, they departed, and lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. And when they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they had were there come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Matthew 2:7-11.
Traveler.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. John 3:16-17. Thanks be unto God for his unmistakable gift. 2 Corinthians 9:15.